This is the story of 90s superstar Penny Hardaway. What's up, guys? It's your boy Miles back with another Swishout video, and I'm doing this video because it was very, very highly requested after my Brandon Roy tragic story. I'm starting a tragic series, so stay tuned for that. If you guys enjoy my content, please subscribe to my channel and turn on my notifications. That's a big thing, but enough with the rambling, guys. Stay tuned, Jake.
I wanna go far, there's no stopping. I see them watching, I see them waiting. One day I swear I'ma be on the station.
Now, Anfernee Penny Hardaway grew up in Memphis, Tennessee, and attended his hometown school, the University of Memphis. But in his freshman season, he had to sit out because he was academically ineligible. And during his freshman season, Anfernee Penny Hardaway was actually robbed at gunpoint and struck by a stray bullet in his foot that could have put his career in jeopardy. But luckily it didn't, and by his junior year, Anfernee Hardaway was averaging 22 points, 8 rebounds, and 6 assists, and had 2 triple doubles, and passed on his senior year to enter the NBA draft. Then in the NBA draft, he was drafted 3rd overall by the Golden State Warriors, but then he was traded for the 1st overall pick, Chris Webber, and ended up in Orlando with Shaquille O'Neal. And in his rookie season, he started out as a shooting guard standing 6'7", but by mid-season, he transitioned to the point guard and had immediate impact, averaging 16 points, 6 assists, and 5 rebounds, helping that team reach 50 wins. And by the next season, Shaq and Penny Hardaway actually led that team to 57 wins and a NBA Finals appearance, actually beating Michael Jordan. But when they got there, a meltdown by Nick Anderson caused this team to lose all confidence and lose in a 4-game sweep to Hakeem Olajuwon and the Houston Rockets. But fast forward to the next season, where Shaquille O'Neal actually missed significant time in the beginning of the season due to injuries, and Anfernee Penny Hardaway responded with a 17-5 record and won the Player of the Month for November. This outstanding performance by Anfernee Hardaway only led to an ego problem between him and Shaq, and they started to question whose team was it really. But Penny Hardaway was looking like he was the new star in town, as he was having Nike commercials with Chris Rock and his action figure Little Penny. And on the other side, Shaq was with Nike's enemies Reebok, and Shaq actually dissed his teammate while he was on the team in a commercial. Take a look at this here.
I got 10 fingers and no rings, and I love jewelry. That's what's on my mind. This is my planet.
You got room for a brother on your planet.
And this only added fuel to the already burning fire. And that offseason, Shaquille O'Neal was not satisfied with the contract that Orlando was offering him, as he thought Orlando believed that Penny Hardaway was more significant to the team, and Shaquille O'Neal ended up signing with the LA Lakers. And nobody can blame him. He won 3 championships with Kobe Bryant, the dude that Penny Hardaway was probably supposed to be, and meanwhile, Penny Hardaway struggled for the rest of his career. In the second season, with Shaq being gone, Penny Hardaway actually suffered a devastating left knee injury, but he still made the All-Star team. But despite having an injury that was probably supposed to put him out for the remainder of the season, Penny Hardaway started in the All-Star game even though he was hurt, and he basically missed the remainder of the season after the All-Star game, and he was highly criticized for it. And in a shortened 1999 season due to a lockout, Penny Hardaway actually led the Magic to the best record in the Eastern Conference, even though he wasn't even the same player that he was before. But in the summer of the next season, Penny Hardaway was traded to the Phoenix Suns to join fellow All-Star Jason Kidd and form a backcourt in which they called the Backcourt 2000. But due to injuries in Penny Hardaway's foot and Jason Kidd's ankle, they only played 45 games together. But they still managed to go 53-29 and get the fifth seed in the West, and they actually met Shaquille O'Neal and Kobe Bryant in the semi-conference finals, but they fell short in just 5 games. And in the next season, with the future looking bright with emerging star Jason Kidd and Penny Hardaway, unfortunately the season was cut short and Penny Hardaway missed 78 games and had to have 2 microfracture surgeries on his left knee. But in the next season, Penny Hardaway's buddy Jason Kidd had been traded to the New Jersey Nets for Stephon Marbury, and this caused Penny Hardaway and Stephon Marbury to clash because Penny Hardaway was used to Jason Kidd, who was a pass-first point guard, and Stephon Marbury was a shooting point guard who basically never passed the ball. But for the remainder of Penny Hardaway's career, he found himself on and off the bench, playing for various teams like the Suns, the Knicks, and eventually the Heat, and unfortunately his career was just never the same. His tragic ACL injury that he had in 1997, mixed with other injuries that he collected during the span of his career, stopped him from reaching his full potential. He's easily one of the biggest what-ifs in NBA history. But that's the Penny Hardaway story, guys. I hope that you enjoyed and learned something. I see that you guys really enjoy my tragic series, so I'm gonna start it on my channel. I have more coming, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a like on the video, comment, and subscribe. And most importantly, turn on my notifications. Hit that little bell so you can get notified every single time your boy Miles posts a video. But that's the video. If you like the video, like the video, do all that good stuff. Until next time, stay tuned.
Running alone, die alone. I let the drugs take my soul. First time I bought some weed, I was sold. If I get 40,000 for a show, I'm scared I'll spend 20,000 on some dope. Either rap for Ricky on my toes. In high school, I never.